In this presentation, we will try to understand different types of recursion. So let's get started. There are basically four types of recursion. First one is direct recursion. The second one is indirect recursion. The third one is tail recursion. And the fourth one is non-tailed recursion. In this particular presentation, we will discuss the first two types, that is direct recursion and indirect recursion. Now let's try to understand what is direct recursion. A function is called direct recursive if it calls the same function again. What does it really mean? Here is the structure of direct recursion. Suppose you have a function fun, and inside this function you are calling this function again. This is called direct recursive. Whatever the programs we have encountered in the previous lectures are all direct recursive programs, right? Direct recursion is simple to understand. But what is indirect recursion? A function, let's say fun, is called indirect recursive if it calls another function, let's say fun2, and then fun2 calls fun again, directly or indirectly. What does it really mean? Let's say we have a function fun, and inside this function you're not calling this function, but you're calling another function, let's say fun2, whose definition is available over here. And inside this function, you are calling fun function. If you observe this code structure carefully, you are calling function fun only, right? This is a recursion for sure. But you are calling this function indirectly, right? You are first calling fun2, and then from fun2, you are calling fun function. This is called indirect recursion. Okay, let me repeat the definition for you. A function, let's say fun, is called indirect recursive if it calls another function, let's say fun2, and then fun2 calls fun directly or indirectly, right? I know it will be a little bit difficult for you to understand the concept behind indirect recursion, and you want to know where indirect recursion is useful. So to address all these doubts, let me give you one program which will help you to understand indirect recursion in better details. Write a program. This is the short form of writing. Write a program. Write a program to print numbers from 1 to 10 in such a way that when number is odd, add 1. And when number is even, subtract 1. You want this program to produce an output something like this. When you encounter an odd number, you should add 1 to it. And when you encounter an even number, you should subtract 1 from it. That's what we have to do, right? And we have numbers from 1 to 10. As we have numbers from 1 to 10, so 1 becomes 2 because the number 1 is odd, right? After that, you encounter number 2. As number 2 is even, therefore we need to subtract 1 from it, so it becomes 1, right? And then after that, we encounter 3. As 3 is an odd number, we have to add 1 to it, so it becomes 4. And then we encounter number 4, which is an even number, so we should subtract 1 from it, so it becomes 3. This is how we need to progress, okay? And this is the output we are expecting. Let's see how we can code this particular program to produce an output something like this. Suppose we have two functions, odd and even. As the name itself suggests, odd function will handle odd numbers and even function will handle even numbers. Whenever an odd number is encountered, it will add 1 to it and print it on the screen. And when an even number is encountered, it will subtract 1 from it and print it on the screen. And suppose we have one variable n, and I'm initializing it to value 1. Basically, this variable n depicts numbers from 1 to 10. Now, here is the definition of the function odd. Inside this function, we have an if construct, and then immediately after that, we have return statement. What does this if construct says? If n is less than or equals to 10, then you will print n plus 1 on the screen. As odd function is going to handle odd numbers, so if suppose we encounter number 1, so it will print 2 on the screen, right? And after that, we increment the value of n so that it becomes an even number, and then we call an even function so that we can handle that number, right? And here is the definition of even function as well. The code of even function is exactly the same as the odd function, but there is one difference you can encounter over here. Instead of n plus 1, you have n minus 1. After this function, we have a main function, and inside this main function, we are calling odd function. Why we are calling odd function? Because the first number we encounter is 1, and it is an odd number. Therefore, we first have to call the odd function in order to handle that number, right? This is the output we are expecting. 21436587109. And now let me simulate this code with the help of stack. This is what we are doing usually, right? When we see recursive programs. Suppose we have a stack like this. And initially, as we know, main function is called. Inside the stack, the activation record of main function will be created, right? Which is denoted by act of M. Act simply means activation record. O means odd function. Whenever you find a symbol O, you should replace this with odd function. And whenever you find the symbol E, you should replace this with even function. Okay? M means main and act means activation record. So basically, what does it mean is you are storing the activation record of this main function inside this stack. Okay? Now, as inside this main function, you are calling the odd function. Therefore, the control transfers to the odd function and the activation record of the odd function will get stored inside the stack. As we have called the odd function, and inside this odd function, as you can see, we have an if construct where we are checking this condition is n less than or equals to 10. As n is initially 1 and 1 is less than 10, it is satisfied. Therefore, we come inside this if construct and we simply print value 2 on the screen, right? And then after that, we increment the value of n so that n becomes 2. And now we simply call even function. This means now the control transfers from odd function to even function and the activation record of even function will get stored inside the stack. Now inside this even function again, we encounter this if construct. As n is again less than 10, because n is equals to 2 and 2 is less than 10, we go inside this if construct. We simply print value 1 on the screen because 2 minus 1 is 1, right? And then after that, we increment the value of n. Now n becomes 3. And then again, we call odd function. Now control will again transfer to the odd function. And the activation record of odd function will be created inside the stack. As value is 3 and 3 is less than 10, again condition is satisfied. We simply print value 4 on the screen. And then we increment the value of n. Now n becomes 4. And we simply call even function. Now the control transfers from odd function to even function. And the activation record of even function is maintained inside the stack. As n is equals to 4 and 4 is less than 10, condition is satisfied. We come inside the if construct and here we will simply print value 3 because 4 minus 1 is 3, right? And then after that you increment the value of n. Now n becomes 5 and we again call the odd function. And the activation record of odd function is also maintained inside the stack, right? Now when n is equals to 5, we print value 6 on the screen, right? And then again value is incremented and even function is called. This process will continue like this way only until and unless we obtain n equals to 11. When we encounter n equals to 11, the condition itself fails and we start returning, right? Now suppose after this point, we are returning. As return means, you will return back to the position where you left off, right? As we are returning from the odd function, the activation record of odd function will get popped out of the stack and we return back to the even function where we left off at this point, right? After this, there is nothing. You have encountered return statement again. This means you will return back to the position where you left off, means you will return back to the odd function at this particular point. And again, after that, you find return. This means you again return back to the even function. And similarly, the procedure continues. You are simply returning back. Finally, you encountered the main function. And as you can see, after this point, there is nothing written. This means this main function will simply pop out of the stack. And the execution is completed. Now, let me execute this code for you and check whether this output, whatever we are expecting, is what we are getting or not. Here is the code which we have seen already. We have an odd function and an even function. And after that, we have a main function. And here we are calling an odd function. Let's see whether this code works fine or not. Yes, it produces the output 21436587109, which is the expected output. Okay, friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.